It's been a ride. I guess I had to go to that place to get to this one. Now some of you might still be in that place. If you're trying to get out, just follow me. I'll get you there.
Eminem is a rap artist who has succeeded in a previously primarily African-American music industry, rap. Rap was an industry dominated by African-American rappers, but Eminem's words, skin color, and his rapping skills have opened up this genre to a wider audience. He not only broke the color barrier, allowing more artists the opportunity to become rappers, but also spoke out against the things happening in his life, speaking out against what he felt was unjust. Eminem took a stand and became a rapper who allowed his words and style to speak for those who often do not speak up on their own. Kid Marshall Mathers III had many struggles to overcome. At just 8 months old, his mother and father split up, leaving his mother to raise him. He never had that chance to have a father figure, and he and his mother spent his childhood living in poverty and moving their homes several times a year.
Yeah, I would change schools 2-3 times a year, and that was probably the roughest part.
They experienced money problems throughout his entire childhood. He was constantly bullied, and this caused him to have deep feelings of anger, depression, and loneliness. When he became a teenager, he began rapping as a way to express his feelings as well as his creativity. While this should have helped him through his struggles, it only added to his rough life, since it brought on more bullying. The rough life continued as he was a white musician trying to break into a genre dominated by African-American artists. Before 1999, individual rap artists were predominantly black, such as Ice Cube, Dr. Dre, and Tupac. One artist, known as Vanilla Ice, was one of the first individual white rappers in the field. However, he didn't make it big in the industry. After his album Ice Ice Baby in 1990, he never managed to keep going. In fact, there was a lawsuit against his most popular song, only bringing him negative attention and discrediting him in the eyes of black rappers. There were a few white rap groups, including the Beastie Boys and Third Base, which all came before Vanilla Ice, and they only were able to last about the same amount of time in the rap industry. Then Eminem came along. The artist took a stand by talking against the things he felt were wrong in life and being extremely successful in a predominantly black industry. Eminem began getting favorable recognition in response to his first album, the Slim Shady LP, which hit the market selling 283,000 copies in the first week. That album went on to be multi-platinum and garner Eminem with 2 Grammy Awards and 4 MTV Music Awards, which was unheard of at the time. Slim Shady provided listeners with ethnically diverse music, which is a combination of pop and rap. This was original and inspirational to already popular rappers and white people who never felt welcome into this community. Eminem allowed artists in this field to break the color barrier in this genre. His original signer, Dr. Dre, never even knew that Eminem was a white artist. He just listened to Eminem's raps, and from then on decided he wanted to work with him. Even though everyone at the label told Dr. Dre not to sign Eminem because he was white, he still signed Eminem with confidence in his ability. But his rap career had only just begun. After that, Eminem made many more albums and earned many more awards, such as his album Recovery winning 6 awards, the Marshall Mathers LP winning 4 awards, and Relapse winning him 2 awards. His fans aren't the only people to realize his talent and passion.
White rapper in a black dominated industry. He showed that you can come in, be original, be artistic, be whatever, and have the talent to do whatever you needed to do if you had the talent.
Other rappers recognize him for his words and skin color, especially black rappers.
Statistically, you know what I'm saying? And Eminem is like definitely sold more records, but as far as artistry and impact on the culture, I think they're in the same category. Nas, Eminem, Jay-Z, Biggie, Pac.
With him, and what's it like to tour Australia with him and be, I guess, friends with Eminem?
Well, man, for me, I'm sure for him too, but I speak for myself. I'm such a huge Eminem fan, and especially from his first 3 albums. I was like all the way in, you know what I mean? I'm still all the way in because he's still amazing. But, you know, that was a point in my life, a very pivotal point in my rap career, my first song I ever made was literally just biting Eminem and Nas.
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
Eminem took a stand and changed rap from being about trash talking or talking about what someone has to it being more than that. He focuses on telling life stories or life experiences and giving to those who share similar struggles. He speaks of being able to overcome all of it and become successful with life. Soon after that, a few other rappers picked up on that outlook, such as J. Cole, who said, "It's silly how big of an Eminem fan I am. It was a very select group of top-notch people that I worship, and Eminem was literally at the top of the list. My first song sounded like an Eminem bite." There were other rappers, such as Big Sean, who said, "Working with Eminem is the greatest feeling of all time. You can just imagine I bought my first CD at Costco. No matter how stressed, the fact that I get to have a conversation with my idol Eminem is a very cool thing." Rap music was open to a bigger race of audiences after Eminem blew away audiences with his rap, while being white in an African-American industry. Rap is now fully accepted and embraced by all other races. Eminem's childhood and recent past have made him the person he is today. Taking a stand for kids and their struggles and doing it in an adverse industry shows his courage and determination for what he believes in. Giving hope while also entertaining is his way of expressing himself without being judged. His life and success is an inspiration to the masses.
Opportunity seize everything you ever wanted in one moment. Did you capture it? Just let it slip.
Have you ever loved someone so much you giving on for? Not the expression, no, literally giving on for. When they know they're your heart and you know you are their armor, and you will destroy anyone who would try to harm her.